sound check without you, and now we won't have time to read me. Are you all over?
Just a little bit, but it's nothing, okay? At least you have the scripts.
Prop list? You're lucky I brought a damn pan.
Hey, Reggie.
The episode's a continuation, right? Not like from the Luke dream battle you wrote a few weeks back.
Alright. See, Lennon Hart right here,
Lady Matilda, you brought her back. I thought you hated her.
Look, I wrote what I wrote, stop thinking on me. And it is the Oklahoma candy. I had to go see production of Oklahoma the other night.
I swear I need glasses. Candy's back.
Yep, just what I expected. Sir Brighton, Giles, Morris, the one-line joke.
Jeez, Reggie, you should be riding drunk more often. This is freaking
good.
Jack, hurry up with the props.
We're going to
do an introduction.
3, 2, 1. You are on the air.
Calling all thrill seekers, danger hunters, rough riders of all ages, broadcasting live from the remote jungles of Botswana is the Explorer Guild home of Clubhouse 2022. In their latest exploits, last time, charming rough rider Landon Cartwright.
That's me.
And sweet witty club raid operator Kenny Portillo.
That's me.
We're off deep into the jungle when they came across a dark and moist cave crawling with bats. In search of the legendary missing Cartograph of Atlantis.
Oh gee, Mr. Cartwright, do we really have to go into this dark and moist cave crawling with bats?
But of course, Candy. Sir Brighton and his hard female henchman, Elsa Finkelschmuck. Are surely trailing us as we speak. And Candy?
Yes, Mr. Cartwright?
Please, it's Landon.
Okay.
And so our brave heroes enter the dark and moist cave. Will they be okay? Let's find out right after this important message. Hello, ma'am. May I ask you a question?
Hello, sir. You sure can.
When you're doing your husband's shirts at home while he's out working an actual job, what laundry detergent do you use?
Why, I use fresh squeezed laundry detergent, the only laundry detergent around that is known to have actual lemon juice squeezed straight into the formula.
Gee, lady, you're practically doing my own job for me. Why don't you get back into the kitchen and do the most important job a woman should do, making anything and everything out of gelatin, with Law Brand Gelatin, another proud sponsor of our Explorers Guild. Shake it, Mama.
Sure thing.
And now back to our show. Landon and Candy proceed into the dark and moist bat cave with caution. Looking around, everything seems dark, and then suddenly a noise.
Oh, Candy.
Meanwhile, a little less deep in the jungle, a devilishly diabolical treasure hunter, Sir Brighton, along with his female henchman, Elsa Finkelschmuck, is closing in on our brave adventurers.
If you do not mind my asking, Frau Finkelschmuck, why am I even paying you if we have yet to even see Mr. Cartwright and his female confidant?
Herr Brighton, if you do not mind my asking, would you rather they know where we are?
Why, no, but...
Delay!
Frau Finkelschmuck, how
dare you! It appears we are being followed.
Suddenly, a black eagle descends upon Frau Finkelschmuck and Sir Brighton. This eagle is none other than Fritz, the espionage eagle.
I see.
What in the bloody hell is that bird saying?
It appears we must prepare for our descent. The secrets of the capital imperialists are never safe until we reach.
Will Elsa and Sir Brighton find our brave all-American heroes? Will the secrets of the cave ring true? Find out right after this important message from our sponsor.
Gee, Mr. Cartwright, traveling through this cave sure is stressful.
You know, Kirby, stress is the number one killer of people overcome. Take a cigarette. Kimberly brand cigarette, clinically proven to reduce stress and prolong life.
Thanks, Mr. Cartwright. I'll light it right now.
Stress makes you a mess.
As Landon and Candy travel deeper into the cave.
Gee, Candy, you see those stalagmites and stalactites on those ground and ceiling?
Gee, Mr. Cartwright, they're really, really big.
Please, Candy, calm your Landon. They're beautiful. Makes you happy not to be a desk jockey.
Gee, it makes me wish I was out there more often instead of fiddling with my radio gadget.
Well, Candy, I've been looking for a female confidant to accompany me on my travels ever since my ex-fiancée, Samantha, tragically disappeared in that odd boating accident in South Siam.
Oh, Landon.
Oh, Candy. Candy, look! This wall opened up romantically once I leaned against the wall to seduce you.
Oh, Landon, you're so romantically smart.
Entering the passageway, the wall romantically slammed shut behind them.
Oh, Landon, it appears we're trapped in here. Just us, that large sunny hole up above, and our romantic desires.
No worries, Candy. Things always look grim before they look better. Let's move deeper into this dark, mysterious cave.
Meanwhile, up above...
Here's our confidants have discovered the hidden chamber.
Yes, now I suggest we start propelling some down this long rope strategically placed at the mouth of this large oak.
Halt, adventuring scum!
Hark! It's our two greatest enemies, treasure hunter Sir Brighton and Thai German mercenary Elsa Finkelschmuck.
Oh, Landon, protect me!
Silence, American Frail!
I'm so insulted!
Ah, Mr. Cartwright. It's absolutely marvelous to see you here. Now, I'd wish to show you my deepest sincerity in showing me the location of this hidden chamber, but... Whenever we meet, you always have that, boisterous American attitude we British just absolutely detest. So, goodbye.
On the air.
And say what? We have a dead body in the studio? Dude, it's a family show, come on!
Must have been the shock of Landon dying.
Why would you kill him off anyway if he was such a popular character? Or, no. Why is the writing in this one just different?
Reggie, did you log the source? That's That's why you hesitated about the prophets. You didn't think there would be one.
You had someone else do it because you were drunk off of your ass and you didn't read it, so you didn't know that Landa died, which killed Daniel. God damn it, Reggie, get your life together.
Alright, look. I didn't have a script, okay? I was leaving the house this morning and I saw it on the floor. So I thought, why not? A fan probably wrote it, so why not do the fan a service and perform it? Was that a crime?
Murder is a crime, Reggie!
Wait a minute. What if that's not entirely what happened? Hey, look. Okay, so Dottie's not a smoker. We know this. But yet during the commercial, she coughed like she'd just taken her first drag off a cigarette. Now we're trapped in this room, like how we're trapped in that chamber. And Daniel's body, it's reacting like it's got shot because that's what happened to his character. This script is cursed, people.
What do you suppose we do, Earl?
Perform the rest of it and have Daniel's body taken up the place?
Show must go on.
That was Pacific and Mama performed by Jimmy Rogers. Now we're back to the Glen exploits of the Explorers Guild.
Landon, no, you monster.
Verds are just verds.
How dare you?
Is that all you've got?
Miss, you know that behavior isn't quite ladylike.
Do it, I dare you.
A trigger is pulled. Will our heroine live to return to her post? Will the Explorers Guild be forced to hold a double funeral? Find out after this important message from Babs Corsets.
Hello there, it's me, Dottie Fitzpatrick, the voice of Candy Portillo and Elsa Fickleschmuck. After a long day of reading scripts of adventure and romance, I'd like to go home and greet my husband with a fresh look that really looks swell. That's why I go downtown to Babs Corsets on 5th and Main. Babs Corsets wear it for him.
Our heroine, Candy Portillo, stands with the fiendish through bright and gunning. Will she survive? Let's find out.
Any last words?
Would you like me to move closer?
Oh, how sweet. A sense of humor. Shame, really.
The trigger is pulled, shooting the wall. It was none other than Bill Boiler Giles using his infamous Explorers Guild crossbow.
I believe you're aiming a gun at an Explorers Guild card carrying employee. I implore you to stop.
Giles, how'd you find this?
We followed the intoxicating smell of Kimberly Brand's cigarettes. The official Explorers Guild cigarette. I'm here to rescue you. Though it appears I'm too late for one, Mr. Cartwright.
We?
That's right! It's me, Morris, the official Guild Grease Monkey!
And I, Lady Matilda, Grand Matron and sponsor of the Explorers Guild.
After nothing but darkness fell over the Black Forest, I realized
I must return to do my secret duty to this guild and all of its inhabitants.
I see you have a few troublemakers making a ruckus. Would you need some assistance?
Using their expert rope-pulling skills, Morris, Big Matilda, and Jarlis led him to the bottom of the chamber. The rope that served by the
bottom of the I'll have to arrange some tidy pickup for dear Landon, and I'll deal with you later.
Then suddenly, without warning, Jarlis the butler collapsed into a tirade of shivers.
Keep reading, we're almost done.
Jarlis, whatever is wrong with you? You've been shivering for half our trip.
The swarm of mosquitoes, madam, I can't be sure, but I think I may have malaria. If I'm not mistaken.
Is that viral?
Will our poor heroes find the lost cartograph of Atlantis? Will our villains escape the detainment they found themselves in? Will Giles be able to get the cure for malaria before the clock runs out? Find out next time on the Explorers Guild. So long, but not goodbye.